Welcome back. And as the BJP continues to face criticism for inducting Mayawati's sacked minister Kushwaha in the party, sources say that its top leaders will not campaign for criminal candidates and those who change their parties. The leaders include L.K. Advani, Murali Manohar Joshi, leader of the opposition in the Lok Sabha Sushma Swaraj, and leader of the opposition in the Rajya Sabha Arun Jaitley. The Election Commission has ordered the covering of statues of Mayawati and elephants in the Noida Park. This is being done as per the Election Code. In the 2004 Lok Sabha elections, Vajpayee's photos on billboards across the country on the Golden Quadrilateral National Highway were covered with cloth. And if this kind of rift wasn't enough, former Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister and former BJP leader Kalyan Singh has also indicated that Kushwaha's induction may have been because of money, but the BJP has hit back, saying, let the CBI probe into this.
रुपये का डील तो नहीं हुआ है भाजपा नेताओं के साथ।
कल्याण सिंह ने कल आरोप लगाया बीजेपी के ऊपर ज्वाइनिंग हुई उसमें करोड़ रुपए लिए गए, जिससे सीबीआई जांच होनी चाहिए। क्या कहेंगे?
सीबीआई जांच जरूर हो जाए, कोई दिक्कत नहीं, इसमें क्या दिक्कत है?
The Congress is of course relieved that the heat is off them with this entire Kushwaha episode. General Secretary Rahul Gandhi, who is on a tour of eastern Uttar Pradesh, is using that to take pot shots at Chief Minister Mayawati.
2007 mein aapne kaha Mayawati ji ko laayenge, puri bahumat ki 208 seaten di aapne unko, kya mila? Kya mila? Lathi danda aur Kushwaha. Lathi danda Kushwaha ji.
The Trinamool Congress has just raised the pitch in its attack against LI Congress Party, with Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee saying the Congress was free to leave the alliance if they choose to do so. Mamata Banerjee also reiterated the Trinamool's charge that the Congress and the CPM had joined hands to work against her party. The Trinamool chief said she has always fought alone and would continue to fight alone. The Congress at the center is playing down the tension. They said it was expected in a coalition.
পেট্রোলের দাম বাড়িয়ে বাড়িয়ে প্রতিদিন ডোমেস্টিক গ্যাসের দাম বাড়ানোর ব্যবস্থা হচ্ছে, তৃণমূল কংগ্রেস প্রতিবাদ করছে, আমি করছি। ফেডারেল স্ট্রাকচারকে টোটাল ইন্টারফিয়ারেন্স করা হচ্ছে এখানে সব ব্যাপারে। আপনারা জানেন লোকপাল বিল নিয়ে আসা হয়েছিল, লোক আয়োগ ছিল না, জোর করে ঢোকানো হয়েছিল, বলা সত্ত্বেও শোনেনি, তারপরেও ভোট করেনি, চলে গেছে। কংগ্রেস যদি মনে করে থাকে সিপিএম এর সাথে চলবে, তাদের দরজা খোলা আছে, তারা যেতে পারেন। সিপিএম কংগ্রেস এখানে একসাথে কাজ করলে তৃণমূল কংগ্রেসকে পাওয়া যাবে না। তৃণমূল কংগ্রেস চোর নয়, ডাকাত নয়, খুনি নয়।
The Andhra Pradesh government has come forward to pay compensation to 60 youth after the National Minorities Commission observed that the youth were targeted by the state police purely on communal grounds. NDTV's Uma Sudhir met Syed Imran, one among the first youth picked up after the Mecca Masjid blast, who was confined illegally, tortured and wrongly implicated, and his whole life turned into a nightmare. He was subsequently acquitted and he has not been shortlisted for the compensation.
A moment of reckoning. Muslim youth who suffered after being wrongly implicated post the Mecca Masjid blast in Hyderabad being given checks as compensation by the Andhra Pradesh government.
A stigma has been attached to their lives. They are not getting married, they are not getting employment anywhere, because this was a false case. They were in jail for 2 years. It has ruined their life profile.
Syed Imran was among the first to be picked up after the blast in the mosque.
They have given me electric shocks on my private parts. I can't even tell you that how painful it was.
The family suffered ignominy and was ostracized. Imran lost his job and was rusticated from his college.
मुझे बोला गया था कि आप जो है 10 साल पाकिस्तान में ट्रेनिंग लेके आए हो. मेरी उम्र थी वो टाइम पे जो है 22 साल. अब 10 साल में जब मैं ट्रेनिंग लेके आता हूँ पाकिस्तान में, तो मैं क्या 12 साल में घर से भाग गया था? मैंने यहाँ पे मेरी कम्प्लीटली 10th मैंने यहाँ पे केंद्रीय विद्यालय से की है, और मैंने इंटर भी सुल्तान अलम जूनियर कॉलेज जो हैदराबाद में ही है वहाँ से, और मैं कभी हैदराबाद से बाहर ही नहीं गया था, तो मैं पाकिस्तान तो दूर की बात है.
After 18 months in jail, Imran was acquitted. He struggled to get back to college, and thanks to his resilience and positive spirit, he now holds a BTech degree. But his past is still haunting his future.
मैं अभी भी वही प्रॉब्लम फेस कर रहा हूँ, क्योंकि मैं कहीं पर जॉब के लिए नहीं जा सकता हूँ. मैं कहीं पर अगर जॉब के लिए जा रहा हूँ, ये लोग आ जाते हैं वहाँ पे इंक्वायरी बोल के. आप क्या चाहते हो? आप मुझे ये समझ में नहीं आ रहा है कि मैं एक नॉर्मल इंसान, मैं एक नॉर्मल जिंदगी जीना चाहता हूँ, आप मुझे टेररिस्ट बना रहे हो.
The irony is that Syed Imran's name was cleared and recommended by a three-member top committee of secretaries, and yet his name does not even figure in the waiting list of those to be awarded compensation. The government's attempt to correct it wrong, not perhaps going completely right. In Hyderabad, with camera person Nazeer Sheikh, Umar Sudhir, NDTV.
How would you react if a terrorist walks in during the middle of a play? You wouldn't want to miss the details, so don't touch that remote.